a country I no longer recognize. It gives me no pleasure to write this essay. In just the last decade, my country has transformed into an unrecognizable land so diverse from my childhood that I weep today. At times, I truly wonder if ISIS has taken hold here, eager to destroy every historical landmark of our heritage through the politically correct process. Among many, including Las Vegas, which people seem to be anesthetized to already, was the one I believe sent us over the top. A terrible tragedy befell the residents of Charleston, South Carolina, in which a man who was seen previously waving the Confederate flag sat in a Bible meeting for an hour and then murdered 9 innocent people, including the pastor. In the aftermath, and I do not mean to brush aside the incredible grace of the families of those murdered by any means, the debate has shifted from the ridiculous to the outright absurd. Not only did politicians and activists around the country lobbying to have the Confederate flag removed from virtually everywhere, but now old monuments and statues started being torn down, Marxist style. There are already cries from so-called Americans to abolish the American flag itself. Some ponder the demolition of the Jefferson Memorial in Washington, D.C., and I shake my head. How did we get to a point in America where we so cavalierly consider destroying our own historical structure just to appease a few dissenters? More to the point, how did said dissenters gain such a powerful voice and opinion? The answer is shocking to anyone who has avoided politics most of their lives, while those who have remained engaged will understand perfectly. Our entire educational system has been co-opted by radical left-wing elements who teach in our universities and churn out far more radicalized pupils than those who emerge unfazed by the indoctrination techniques employed therein. These former pupils then immerse themselves into every aspect of the American system, most notably our media, and the results are not very difficult to observe. Born of necessity, alternate news sites have emerged in the internet age, but are easily marginalized by the progressive machine, and results have filtered down even to the consumers of these sources. We are losing America, folks, and I'm not sure if we can reverse course. As government continues to grow, and as all three branches continue to morph into a giant conglomerate of the same ideology, the sane among us continue to be cast aside as heretics, and we are losing ground. We are legion across this nation, but we are disconnected. We must find a way to organize, a phrase I am loath to use, into a network of people determined to save our country before it is too late. We must put forth the message that our history, for all its warts, is an important reminder of how far we have come. Today, black and white Americans interact as though a chasm never existed between us, and yet, our first black president has succeeded in driving a wedge between us large enough to nearly cause complete chaos. Our friends of the opposite color remain as before, but inner-city kids have taken the MAUIST wannabes message a bit too far, and the mainstream media has only stoked the flames. And supposedly well-meaning professors and celebrities have done far more harm in our collective relations. I estimate we have but one more chance, a last chance, if you will, to set this once great nation back on the course originally laid before us by the very men who are so cavalierly vilified on a daily basis. We'd better do it before the next election cycle, because I believe if the 2016 election were to be held today, we might just well have very different results and even a different country, which I don't recognize now.